For both of these boxers, and Hearns, with his usual height advantage, he came in a half pound under Kinchin at 165 and a half, Kinchin at 166, both of them easily under the 168 limit. The 10-point must system is in use here by the NABF, and as you can see, again, the judge is doing the scoring, not the referee. Three knockdown rule, however, is in effect, meaning that if there are three knockdowns in a round, the bout will be stopped. Now let's go to our ring announcer for the introductions. Here's Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is approved by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Chairman Dr. Elias Ghanem. The commissioners are Freddie Little, Herb Santos, Dwayne Ford, and Dr. James Nave. It is sanctioned by the North American Boxing Federation, NABF Supervisor Sam Macias. The winner of this bout, ladies and gentlemen, will be recognized by the World Boxing Organization as the Super Middleweight Champion of the World. The three judges are Bill Graham, Larry Rosadilla, and Cindy Barton. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the Las Vegas Hilton in Las Vegas, Nevada, let's get ready to rumble 12 rounds for the NABF and WBO Super Middleweight Championship. The referee for this bout is Mills Lane. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the Kronk gold colors and weighs 165 and one half pounds. From the Motor City, Detroit, Michigan, his professional record, 45 victories, 38 by KO, only three defeats. Ladies and gentlemen, the only man in boxing history ever to win four world championships in four different divisions, in four different battles, the Hitman, Thomas Fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the red trunks with white trim and weighs an even 166 pounds from San Diego, California. His professional record, 43 victories, 30 by KO, only four defeats and two draws. He currently holds the NABF Super Middleweight Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, James the Heat Kinchin.
Well, the referee is Mills Lane, and he will bring the boxers in the middle of the ring as James the Heat Kinchin doffs his flame robe. And here's Mills Lane.
Any questions over here? Any questions over here? Let's get it on. Come on.
Well, Thomas Hearns trying to get that last stare into James Kinchin, who just didn't give him the opportunity. Kinchin 43-4-2. Thomas Hearns 45-3, each of them 30 years of age. Huge difference in title fight experience. 14 championship fights for Thomas Hearns. He's the former WBA welterweight champion, WBC super welter champ, WBC light heavyweight champion, and WBC middleweight champ. And he is taking on a guy in his first really, really big fight, James Kinchin, but he is the defending NABF super middleweight champion.
As Hearns landed a couple of good left jabs, and Kinchin smiled at him, Tim. But watching Kinchin in the gym, he eats those left jabs.
And there's one of the underlooked weapons of Thomas Hearns, the left hook to the body.
Good combination scored by Hearns. And a good right hand that wobbled Kinchin.
Well, it's the vintage Thomas Hearns first round, isn't it?
Well, you're not kidding.
Oh, my.
One thing, he's not punch shy after that punch out with Iran Barkley. He's letting it all hang out.
And he's been nailed with a couple overhand rights by Kinchin, but they haven't done the damage that the Barkley right did.
Impressive opening flurries by Thomas Hearns. Kinchin having a little difficulty getting close enough against the taller, longer-armed Hearns in this early going.
Kinchin has a pretty good left hook to the body. You would think he would want to get that off on the inside, try and cave Hearns in a bit.
Thing is, Al, he has to get inside.
Yeah.
So far, Tommy's been using that left hand pretty good to keep him right within punching range. There's that left hand again. Snappy left hand.
I feel, though, that you just kind of sense Kinchin after what happened with Barkley feels like he'll take his shot. If he can get one good one in, he feels like he might be able to hurt Hearns and put him down. Whether he can is debatable.
Good combination by Kinchin. Right hand on the end of it that landed.
He's been hit by some pretty good punches by Tommy Hearns, and he's taken the punches pretty well.
And Kinchin is throwing good combos. I'll tell you, James Kinchin is a much better boxer since he moved up in weight. He's reeled off 6-7 straight wins. Not against champions or top contenders, but he's looked good in doing it.
Kinchin winning this title on October 13th of this year. And Marvin Mack, a vacant NBF crown. Good right hand landed. That.
And once you get that left hand working well, you can feint the jab after you get it working and get those combinations off. That's why that left jab is so important.
Oh, get back.
Tell you what, though, James Kinchin has been within punching range better in this first round than I ever imagined he would be in this bout.
Weighed in at 165 and a half, Kinchin 166, and now you pointed out he's very comfortable with this weight. Kinchin, good right hand by Kinchin. Backed up Hearns. Bell sounds in round one, and Kinchin with a little bit of a confident stare at Hearns, and let's go to the corner of Thomas Hearns. Manuel Stewart, the instructions from him.
I know, okay, listen, relax yourself. Hey, this is a great build. That's all right. Forget it. Okay, I need some grease. Give me water.
Tending to a little swelling under the right eye.
Some grease,
I believe.
I need some grease.
Let's give it to him. Let's give it to him, man.
Got the Inswell on there, Gil, or are they working on a little nick?
They were using Inswell on both eyes. I mean, I don't know why. It didn't seem to me that his eyes would have swollen, but they sure went to work on him.
Something from sparring perhaps left over.
Take everything down.
Very well be.
Some swelling that they had, so they knew right away to go to work on it. There is a little swelling there.
So round number two, Thomas Hearns in gold. James Kinchin, the NABF champ, in red. Firing, he did that in round one, not wanting to give the opportunity to Kinchin to duplicate the feat of Barkley.
Hey, Tommy doesn't throw too many right hands better than the one that just landed.
Right on the button, and Kinchin didn't even blink.
Nothing. It's a bad sign for Tommy Hearns, although the next one could just as easily put Kinchin out.
There it is again.
And it didn't.
And firing back is James Kinchin.
This is the kind of fight that it gets to be, not who's the better pitcher, but who's the better catcher.
There are few better pitchers than Tommy Hearns. He's had trouble catching on occasion. Been a night replete with low blows, and there's another one.
Kinchin talking to Hearns now. He's battling with confidence here in round number two. Good jab by Kinchin, finding some range now.
Tommy keeps that left hand right down by his knee. Such a tempting target to try to throw a right hand over that jab.
Round two scheduled for 12. Body shot by Kinchin, and Hearns indicating it was a little low, but no damage.
Well, there is the theory, one that I'm not sure I don't subscribe to, that Tommy Hearns is about a 3 or 4 round fighter these days, and you see signs as he gets into those rounds of everything eroding with him. Let's see what happens tonight.
Thomas Hearns, 30 years of age, 48 professional bouts, only 3 defeats,
and you know, most of his good punching wins were against middleweights, junior middleweights, and welterweights. Now he's hitting a bigger man now, and I think there is a difference because he's landed his perfect punch 3 or 4 times, and so far nothing's happened.
Right hand over hand right from Kinchin scored. Bangs in the body low again. Kinchin keeping some pressure on her.
Well, this is right where James Kinchin wants this fight, where he can work the body with the left and the right hand and come up with that left hook.
talking about Hearn's punching success against the smaller men. You really have to throw out that Andre's light heavyweight fight because that was simply an overmatch in terms of skill. And round number two will follow the champion, James Kinchin. His
nice
handlers,
Wes Wambold. Nice and relaxed. You got to believe. Trainer.
Derek, one of the many stars at ringside here tonight, coming to see this Super Fights triple header at the Las Vegas Hilton. And this is a genuine fight fan. A lot of people might think, well, it, you know, she just shows up to get the publicity. It's not the case at all. She is a genuine and knowledgeable fight fan, and she comes to all of them.
You gotta believe.
Well, Wes Wambold didn't offer much in the way of instruction. He's happy with the way his charge is going. You gotta believe. That's probably good advice for the way Kinchin's starting.
Kinchin does have confidence in himself, Tim. He started smiling at Tommy and talking to him right from the beginning of the fight.
Well, he scored the first round for Hearns very close, and round two for Kinchin.
It's been a long time coming for James Kinchin, as you said, Tim, to be in a major fight where he could get a lot of attention. So he's relishing the fact that he's here and not trying to make the most of it.
Lost four times, and he's got wins over some pretty tough customers: Odell Hadley, Murray Sutherland, Alex Ramos, Buster Drayton, Frankie Minton twice, winning the NBF title for Marvin Mack just 3 weeks ago.
And Minton is actually taunting him. Hearns lands a couple of good punches, and Kinchin compliments him. He's talking to him.
That hook downstairs by Kinchin, warned by Mills Lane, but that's what he wants. He wants to get that left hook in there. I'll tell you, if I was James Kinchin, I wouldn't worry about points being deducted or warnings or anything, because you're not going to win this fight by decision anyway. If you're going to win it, it's probably going to come by knockout in the middle or later rounds. If you lose it, it's going to be by knockout.
Busy with the jab, but less effective in landing it here so far in round number three. Good defense by Kinchin. He lands a jab.
Kinchin has had a tendency in the past to bust up a little bit and swell around the eyes. Hearns is landing lots of jabs.
I think most of them in this round, though, have been taken on the gloves and arms of Kinchin. That one gets through cleanly. Right inside by Hearns. The right sneaky right up low and swinging over the left hand of Hearns, and that's something you usually comment on, Gillette. It's an inviting target where Hearns carries the left.
Hearns just wobbled a little bit, Tim, and it wasn't too hard a punch. Here with that looping right hand. Kinchin has that trick. He shifts his weight over to the left and then throws the right hand.
Well, it's time for Thomas Hearns' legs to start going, after all. It's toward the end of the third round.
Oh, a sharp right by Hearns, but didn't move Kinchin at all. It was a good scoring punch. Round, but Kinchin certainly, I think, has indicated to Hearns that this is not going to be an easy evening. I don't think Hearns was coming in overconfident, but it was his hope to come out and blow Kinchin away early.
Yes, I think that was the Manny Stewart's plan to have him come out, snap that jab, get him off balance, and get him out of there. But right now, it's not happening. And here's Mike Tyson, as usual, a great fight fan, enjoying the fights.
I had to kid him earlier about the little extra weight that he's carrying around. He needed an extra large warm-up suit to to hide the extra weight he's carrying. He's going to have a tough training job to get ready for his next fight. Depends on when that, depends on when the fight is, Tim. Well, if it's a year away, he's got plenty of time. Yeah, I think he's still, he's got a lot to lose. Reports saying he's up over 250.
He's a glowing boy.
Yeah. Round number four. Hearns in gold, Kinchin in red. The NABF super middleweight title at stake. It's held by James Kinchin. Thomas Hearns wanting badly to get back into the world title picture with a big significant fight. Of course, the usual talk about a rematch with Sugar Ray Leonard, depending on events here on Monday night.
Right-hand leads, right?
Yeah, yeah, he's been effective with that.
It's not really a booming right hand because his weight has already shifted, but it's sneaky because you think the left hook is coming.
Low blow from Kinchin again. Having a little bit of trouble with the height, I think, of Hearns, because he's throwing those punches where they land on most guys that he's facing. But that tall Tommy Hearns creates a problem. And he did get a warning, and Mills Lane saying if it happens again, here's a problem.
The overhand right of Kinchin, he saw that Barkley fight. He watched it closely. He's throwing those rights, and occasionally he's landing. And if they don't hurt Hearns now, they could in the future in this coffin.
Now Tommy's trying something different. He's waking up a little bit. Fencing with his hands, with both hands, and then throwing those darting punches.
Kinchin knocks him down. Kinchin walked right in and threw a right hand that sent Hearns to the canvas.
That's close, Tim.
Thomas Hearns is still wobbly as Mills Lane looks him over, and we're in the fourth round.
Well, we saw last round he just got tapped and he wobbled a little bit, Tim.
His legs are gone.
Kinchin pouring it on, but he can't get a clean shot so far.
Kinchin better be careful. Hearns is still winging those right hands.
Again, an overhand right sends him back to the ropes. And
legs are gone, Tim.
Hearns into a shell there. Trying to stay
legs
up.
Are gone.
The fourth round is when Tommy Hearns fades.
Hearns wants to hold on. Mills Lane just not big enough to separate them. Hearns buys a little rest time there, holding on, but Kinchin wings another right. Hearns doing what he has to do here, hang on.
Mills Lane could disqualify him if this keeps up. He could easily disqualify Hearns.
He has to talk to him.
He's got it.
He has to talk to Hearns. He hasn't talked to him.
No, he hasn't. He seemed more intent on trying to muscle him apart. The left sends Hearns walking back again. Kinchin pouring it on, but he can't seem to get a clean shot. Hearns trying to stay close and grab. Again, Lee finally gets him separated. Final seconds of round four. Hearns trying to get his feet underneath. Dancing a little bit. Yeah, you thought it was a left hook that sent him to the canvas. There we see Hearns. You can see he's still in difficulty. They're working on him.
Tim, in the third round, I noticed that he just got tapped with an overhand right and started to wobble a little bit. Just can't take a punch. Let's see here
what sends him down. There's the looping right hand. Tremendous shot. And it's the left that sends him down, but I really think it was that right hand that knocked
hand
him. Yeah, knocked him back into the padding. And then the left was just enough to have him drop right there.
And a significant development, a point was taken away as we look at Tommy Hearns go down by Mills Lane for the holding of Tommy Hearns, appropriately so.
They did take one, did they?
Yes.
Yeah.
So what was already a 10-8 round at least ends up being probably a 10-7 round.
Now Hearns will have to fight with some desperation here in the fifth. He has not been a middle of the late rounds fighter in his most recent fights. Mentioned the opportunity of a lifetime here, coming in as a substitute 3 weeks after winning this NABF crown for Marvin Mack. He put himself right back into the thick of the world title pictures and some paydays ahead.
Now, Kinchin should not make the mistake of trying to punch too hard. Just keep throwing those combinations. You don't have to hit Tommy too hard. You just have to hit him clean.
watching, patient, trying to find the shots. And Hearn's doing a good job of getting himself back together here, using his feet.
Well, that's that experience of the veteran champion. That's what he is, Tim.
Remember the days when Tommy Hearns could do this over 12 rounds or even close to 15 as he almost pulled off against Leonard when he was hurt. Those days are gone, though.
Kinchin ripped the right hand, just grazed the nose of Hearns. Kinchin stalking well, stalking patiently. Good right hand lead by Hearns.
And Kinchin just laughed at him, Tim. There's another right hand by Tommy Hearns.
Kinchin lands one of his own in the air, not a whole lot on it.
Set the pace.
Hearns actually looks better now than he did sitting on the stool between rounds.
Hitting a bigger, well-conditioned man, Al, makes a big difference. That's why we have weight divisions in boxing.
Take your time, let us flow.
Kinchin,
a lot of weight divisions.
Too many.
He's, certainly very patient, very much in control here. Looks quite relaxed to me.
It's been a pretty good round, though, for Tommy Hearns.
Yeah, absolutely. Nice form by Kinchin. Hearn certainly has got himself back very well after a knockdown on round number four. Movement been a bit of a problem for Kinchiner trying to get close again to Hearns. At the end of round number five, so Tommy Hearns did a good job getting himself back into it. Jabbing and moving, showing enough legs to sustain himself in round six.
Just keep talking to yourself and keep moving and letting the juices flow.
Here we see Tommy Hearn. I think he's hurt. Sets up. Kinchin lands a beautiful straight right hand, and there's Kinchin smiling at him.
Make him keep pivoting in and out, in and out.
Daniel Stewart wants more of the same, telling Hearns in and out.
And Tommy seems to be breathing.
Take him to school. Take him to school.
With difficulty, Tim. Gasping for breath.
Well, he used up a lot of mileage there circling the ring.
Like
it was an effective strategy in round five, but I think you're raising the question, how long can he do that?
And that's the first time Tommy Hearns has been into the fifth round since March of 1987.
How many fights since then?
Only two.
Round number six, scheduled for 12.
This is an important round in the fight. Kinchin has to turn it around again.
And that's the way to do it, I think. Ripping left hooks to the body.
And to the right. That turns in trouble again. Another right land. Overhand rights. Landing at will. Hearns, good shot. Inside.
Again, it's the pitcher and the catcher.
It's never boring when Hearns steps to the ring, that's for sure.
But one thing Tommy doesn't like is heart and competitive spirit. There's no question about that.
Looking stronger here in the sixth. Punching a low snap again.
He may have stunned Kinchin fighting off those ropes. Kinchin made a wise move going back down to the body, and I think that would stand him in good stead here again.
Hearns is ripping some pretty good left hooks underneath.
That's a warning from Mills Lane for the last one low.
Tommy's mouth is wide open.
We're watching him grab on there after he was knocked down in round number four. Really quite a turnaround, that experience showing through. You remember back many years ago to the Leonard fight when he simply didn't know how to do that because he never had to, knocking everybody out. Got himself all kinds of trouble. But that has no
looping right hand.
This feels like a race against time for Tommy Hearns. Could he knock Kinchin out before he wears out?
And you just keep waiting for Kinchin to land that good clean punch again to see how Tommy reacts.
As he keeps backing into the corner, Tommy will find out, and we'll all find out. Kinchin is short right now, a lot on it. Hearns has counterpunched well off those ropes, though, in this round.
Sharp in the right hand, low with the left. And Mills Lanes was not in position to see that punch there. Otherwise, I think the point would have been deducted from Kitchen. Tommy is getting tired. End of the round. Round number six.
And now we've got an opportunity to talk with the champion who was defeated earlier tonight, Matthew Hilton. Let's join him with Jim Hill.
All right, Tim, thank you very much. Matthew, you mentioned you came into the bout tonight with an injury.
Yeah, I had on the left-hand side, I had a floated cartilage or whatever they were calling it. And I wasn't in good enough condition to train. I never sparred in 3 weeks. But I'm not making any excuses. Robert Hines was the champion tonight. And I'm 22 years old, and I'll be back.
It appeared that you started to run out of gas about the fifth or sixth round.
I started running gas around the third, fourth, and then I felt great after, but I really couldn't do anything. I'm not a right-hand fighter, and I was trying to fight with my right hand because every time I threw my left hand, it hurt me worse than it hurt him. And I don't know how to box. I'm not a boxer, and I had to box, and that's the way it went. But Robert Hines is a champion. He's a very good boxer. He get up off the canvas and get up and won, and that was great.
Thank you very much. Tim, back to you now.
All right, Matthew Hilton, and an exciting young man. We hope to see him back soon. There have been rumors about him having injured ribs, and I guess that's what he was describing there, some kind of an injury to his body that he felt had some effect, but it was classy of him to credit Robert Hines with a terrific come-from-behind off-the-canvas victory. We're in round number seven here. Hearns in gold, Kinchin in red. Hearns has rallied well in rounds five and six.
Kinchin using the jab to work his way in. It's not a strong jab, but gets him there. Should then try those shots to the body and the head like that.
Look at that beautiful move by Tommy Hearns there. If I was Kinchin, I'd grit my teeth and let it all hang out right about now. He slowed down quite a bit, and I think it's more mental than anything else, Al.
I think you're right. I think at this point, he's shocked that Hearns is still there. I think in his mind, he was programmed to think, if I hurt Tommy Hearns any time in the third to sixth round, he's going, and he didn't go.
Good right hand by Hearns. Round seven scheduled for 12. Tim Ryan, Gil Clancy, Al Bernstein. Jim Hill bringing you this action live from Las Vegas, the Las Vegas Hilton. Super fights, a triple header. This is the finale, Hearns and Kinchin.
Kinchin is just pushing one jab out there one at a time. He has to feint the jab, sometimes double the jab, and Tommy's going to start timing that. Just throws one jab.
And there he tried to throw the right over the jab of Kinchin. Hearns did.
One jab with Kinchin.
There he did, and then he fainted to the body, but never threw anything.
Less than he was chagrined himself with that right hand lead missing.
He's letting Tommy get his rhythm back now.
Prince has not been landing many punches here, though. He's had a hard time. There's a good jab, but he hasn't been that accurate.
30 seconds to go in this round. Neither fighter able to assert himself.
Again, here's a case where Kinchin has the opportunity that he's wanted so long. He should let it all hang out.
This is his career right here at the age of 30 in a weight division where he's been fighting better against the guy who, let's face it, isn't what he once was. So it is an opportunity for him. Tommy, to his credit, hanging in there.
At the end of round seven, not really a much of a round for either guy. Neither of them able to assert a pace or a dominance to it, but I think your point about Kinchin's role here is correct. He simply has to be the guy that's going to go punch chase him, pick it up, pick up the pace. Let's listen to Wes Womble.
He's backing up, so you got an advantage. Okay, you got an advantage, and you're the aggressor, but you got to throw some punches behind it. Okay, you got to relax, let your punches flow. I want a left hand, I want a right hand. While the left hand's in the man's face, I want to see a right hand. I want to see a left hook behind the right hand. I want you to hit the body. I want you to relax. Confidence, combinations, and concentration. That's enough. Give me 40.
The three C's.
Damn, holding his head. Grab the arm.
You're too young to remember the three C's.
Okay.
Stop.
So Tommy Hearns will come out for round number nine against James Kinchin, and having rallied rather well here since the knockdown in round four, make it to round number eight. We're in round number eight, pardon me. And James Kinchin getting the advice from his corner to continue to be aggressive and to throw more punches. Wes Womble said that the Hearns is backing up. That's your opportunity, but you've got to throw combinations.
Also, he has to put a little more snap on that jab. He's thinking past the jab, and he's just pushing one jab out at a time. He has to try to hit something with the jab.
Does.
Listen to me again, huh?
Yeah.
Do you and I have to be in the fighter's ears tonight or what? I know you trained fighters for a long time, Gil, but they're not supposed to listen to you from down here.
He's still going to put a little more snap in that jab.
The other thing I think Kinchin started to do in the fifth and sixth round a little bit was work that body of Tommy Hearns, and now he's abandoned that.
I see a beautiful combination for Kinchin. He starts moving Tommy back with that left jab. He's got to throw a straight right hand to the body and then come back up to the chin. Even if Tommy blocks the punch, he's going to bring Tommy right with the punching range.
What we're seeing here these last two or three rounds is Hearns doing the boxing, counter-punching, boxing and moving as though he's looking to score this victory by
now
points.
Throw that right hand to the body. Anytime Tommy's back touches the rope, instead of trying to think, just get it off. As his trainer said, let the punches flow.
Tommy really getting caught against the ropes a lot now and in the corner.
Tired out. Hearns is a tired fighter.
Hinton trying to find an opening. Hearns just covering up, resting on the ropes.
Good right hand on the chin by Kinchin.
Right got through the guard of Hearns.
Excellent body shots.
Well, Kinchin taking advantage of Hearns' rest, and then he fires off with a right hand. But he's straightened up by a right back from Kinchin.
What heart that Tommy Hearns has. That's why this guy was a champion. The champion's heart. What a competitor. Doesn't have much left, but whatever he has, you're going to see it.
And he's wailing with that right hand. I'm sure James Kinchin thought, this is it, I've got Tommy right now, and he didn't.
Under the 30-second mark we go in round eight. Exchange right hands.
We're back to your theory about the pitcher and the catcher, Joe.
That's what it is. Kinchin's a much better catcher thus far in the fight. Every time Tommy, good luck. Tommy's one of his best punches in a fight.
And a right hand from Hearns. Combination fell short with the right hand. Scored with the jab again as the bell sounds. Ending round eight. What a finish to that round.
What a finish. Making it very tough on the judges, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I would score for Kinchin, but you're right. It's tough on the judges. That's going to be one of those. Tommy Hearns leaning against these ropes, is taking a lot of shots, covering up and resting, and then suddenly fired out with a big right hand there.
Kinchin doing the right thing, going to the body, but Tommy blocking a lot of those shots as well.
Well, I've got Kinchin ahead here, not by much. watch, he does have the knockdown going for him in round four. And the point taken away. And the point taken away. The low blows.
Well, point taken away from Hearns for the holding.
Yeah, that's right. So the knockdown, the point taken away, that gives Tommy a pretty big hill to climb.
The holding, right. I said low blows. Pardon me, Al, you're correct. The holding against Hearns, costing him a point.
That's the way Kinchin has to jab. He has to snap that jab like he means something, like he means to hit the guy with it. It's amazing the way fighters' minds work. I've had fighters go out and pour with their jab, pour with it, and it would just be a little short. They go back to the corner and say, I want you to hit the guy with the jab in the front and out the back. And the guy would go, oh! And then the next round, he'd be able to nail him with the jab, which is concentration. He's getting that jab in now, Kitchen. It's always one jab. That's dangerous. Tommy tried to count low, low blow by Kitchen.
You know, Tim, when you said low blows, it might have been psychological because we keep thinking maybe one would be taken away from Kitchen for
yes,
low
Yes, right.
Blows.
Exactly right.
Psychologically, it's possible.
Kitchen is getting to Tommy Hearns with a stiff jab now. And Tommy, again, is looking to count with the right hand.
A lot of swelling over the right eye of Tommy Hearns. Who would have thought this fight was going into the ninth round?
I don't think Tommy Hearns had any idea of it being in the ninth round.
And I'm sure Kinchin, in his dreams leading up to this fight, just only could imagine it getting this far, because I'm sure he feels this is where he wants it to be.
His attack is very unimaginative. Same thing. Push that one jab out.
Gets that right to the body that you wanted in control, you thought would be effective. You did get there.
This is certainly an unexpected scenario at this point.
Now is when he should throw that right hand to the body.
Tommy Hearns getting off the floor and now boxing as though he's trying to win it on points.
Oh, because Kinchin waits too long. Tommy gets on the ropes and Kinchin stands and tries to figure something out. You don't figure, you just throw. Big right hand by Tommy Hearns.
Aren't people supposed to go down when Tommy Hearns lands those punches? Kinchin isn't.
No, in fact, he hasn't even been able to back him up with him, even though, of course, they're scoring blows. Swelling now more evident around the right eye of Hearns. There's a left hook face, a good one from Kinchin. As we reach the final seconds of the ninth round. So three to go. In a fight that figured to be a knockout one way or the other, and with most people figuring it would be from Tommy Hearns early, here we are headed toward the 10th round.
You all right? Not hurt?
What?
Not hurt?
No.
Nice and relaxed. Don't get careless in there. Don't get careless in there. You'll land the shot. Nice and relaxed. You don't tell him nothing, Doc. I tell him. Nice and relaxed. Deep ones. You're letting him get off a little bit on you. Okay, you got to keep that head moving from side to side, up and down. I want to see you moving in behind punches, and I want to see that right hand. I want to see the left hook behind it. I want your punches to flow. Don't try for nothing. It'll come.
Come on, something.
Nice and relaxed.
Swambold's counsel to James Kinchin, defending his NABF super middleweight crown against Tommy Hearns, and Tommy Hearns into the 10th round. Hasn't been there for a long time.
This was the round in which he knocked Dennis Andres out back in March of 1987. So far, though, none of those right hands, as you mentioned, have really hurt James Kinchin or appear to have hurt him.
Kinchin has to fire a little more, though, Al.
Well, I agree with you. I think he should be certainly more aggressive and take a few more chances. This is it. This is his moment in the sun.
And he knows he's had the guy down. He knows he hurts the guy when he hits him, and he's just not letting it all out. Not letting it all hang out. There's no tomorrow.
And he also must know that this is a pretty close fight.
Look at the opportunities he has. To let, even if the guy blocks the right hand, he's going to move him backwards, move him against the ropes, but he's not letting it go.
And he's in position to throw those punches.
That's right. He's in perfect position. Yeah, we were talking about that right hand to the body. Every time Tommy's back touches the ropes, you can throw that right hand to the body. The worst that's going to happen is he's going to left off by hand. Something better get Kenshin mad because he's... Talk and let the gloves do the talking.
And you're right. Boy, he's jabbing, and the right hand is right there for him. He's just not sure it is.
And always to the head. Throws it to the body, and he'll land that left hook.
Right hand lead, and then a slapping right hand to the ear of Hearns.
He just won't gamble, Al. Maybe that's why he's always been one step behind the parade.
Very possible. And I'll tell you, Tommy Hearns trying to use the jab to keep him off. Now Kitchen's walking through that jab pretty well, though.
Hearns, right eye swelling more evidently now. It could be a problem for him soon. We're in round number 10. Again, it's the pace of this that seems to be the problem for Kitchen. He's simply got to pick it up. I don't see how he can and not be going after this guy. The fact that he's NABF champion doesn't mean really much at all.
It doesn't mean a thing as far as I'm concerned. When the bell rings, there's no champion. If the winner is the champion when the fight's over.
And the reputation of Tommy Hearns, if there is something to be said either way, would supersede the NABF crown that Kinchin has in the scoring, if such a thing had an impact.
Well, we hear his trainer holler heat in the final seconds.
Been that bad around though.
No, not bad, but again, not what you would expect under the circumstances. Not enough pressure, not enough fire, not enough heat.
Well, I think he won the round though, Tim.
You gonna make it on down the stretch?
Yes,
it comes to too long a trip, not only just for this fight, for everything.
Round up, man.
Thomas, listen to me, son. When you fire 1-2, I want the right hand right in the middle of the forehead. You'll take him out of there if you do that.
Christian, you got to take off the clock, okay?
Okay.
You got to keep the left hand up and keep moving. As long as you got your left hand up, you got it okay. Keeping your left hand up. Yeah. Keeping the left hand up good, okay?
Come on, Tommy. Fire that right hand right there. Right smack in the middle. Snappy one. Right in the forehead.
Looking good.
Two 30-year-old warriors come out for round number 11.
I don't know why Tommy Hearns wanted to touch gloves. Maybe he thinks it's the last round.
Kinchin could have nailed him in that instance.
Well, there are two to go, and I would think that the fight is on the line in these last couple of rounds. We must go back to round 4, a knockdown scored by Kinchin, a point taken away from Hearns. They're holding. Otherwise, going out that round, a very close fight the way we see it. I don't know how the judges are seeing it, but...
Of course, that becomes a three-point round. So
yeah.
Three rounds Tommy has to make up. So, because Tommy has had no two-point rounds.
Jabs by Hearns.
Oh, there's that nice right to the body. Now that one was a good one.
Good left counter from Kitchen.
Then he should jump right on him.
Tim,
he's too mechanical. There's no emotion, no fire.
No heat.
No heat in the kitchen.
That's right.
In the kitchen.
But it's really true that has been a problem for James in his career. He's had some skills, certainly was a very skillful fighter 4 or 5 years ago, but there seemed to be that one element missing, and maybe it was the emotion in the fire, which makes his nickname more ironic.
And Tommy's wobbling around in now. Looks very, very weak right now.
This is the opportunity of a career right now for Kinchin. And for Tommy, they said to him in the corner, not just this fight, everything is on the line. Then you ask yourself, can Tommy Hearns get a big fight after this, win, lose, or draw, the way he's fought?
The answer probably yes, but
sentiment, period.
It's my sentiment, Al. He's done it all. All he has to do is just lunge in and take chances.
Tommy has slowed perceptibly here in this 11th round. Not as much movement, not as many punches.
This is the round that Kinchin should try to do it. Because once they get to that lane, look at Kinchin. He thinks he's got all day. I mean, next round, 3 minutes. It's not as bad when you only have 3 minutes to go as when you have six. Tommy can grit his teeth and maybe get through. But this guy should be letting it all hang out now.
He got butted. I think there was a bang, a clash of heads, and it maybe did more damage to Kinchin there. Slowed him up there.
There's the shot. There's that right hand to the body. Wow. Good punch.
And he really sat down on that punch as well.
Tommy has to let him. If he wants to get in this round, he's going to have to throw a couple of punches too.
Good right hand by Hearns. Good right hand knee by Hearns. But he wobbles back. His legs are just not just a tired guy. But what a job he did. Thomas Hearns. Wobbling back to his corner, but he scored the better punches at the end.
He's doing it all on the lot. And memory, experience.
Keep your hands up. He'll be swinging wide. He'll be trying to catch you with the right hand. Keep your hands up.
You know what to do. You know what to do. Win the round.
Well, a big surprise of this is that it's in the going into the 12th round, gentlemen. Certainly is a big surprise. Tommy Hearns, a great offensive fighter. Just about anybody he ever fights, if they're in there with him for a while, they're either out or badly hurt. Well, he goes.
Yeah, that to me is the real astonishment, that Tommy's been able to go 12 rounds after being hit with some good shots, enough body shots to have some impact, though not as many as I think Kinchin would like to hit him with.
Well, credit to his training and his guts and his stamina and his championship experience. The final round.
Hearns leaned in and James Kinchin threw about five very hard punches, so he said, I better go after this now.
Hearns' right eye is starting to close a little.
Tommy doesn't have any legs at all.
Nothing.
No legs. Kinchin should be able to feel that.
It's up to Kinchin now, totally.
If he just throws anything, hits him hard on the arms, he's gonna move him. Kinchin is fighting the way I would call it a sparring partner mentality. Like he's in the gymnasium. Okay, fix your headgear. The headgear, put down over your eyes, you know.
Right hand on Hearns.
But a good count is fighting. Look at Hearns, doesn't have a leg under him. He's still landing punches.
At least, though, that is making Kinchin fight back. This is an astonishing 12th round.
Well, Bill, your point is still there. He goes right back to kind of marching in, going
to the motion. Throw the jab, look for something, instead of letting the other punches go. Tommy has all the fire. No legs and all fire. Now Kinchin should get right on.
Also, every time Kinchin lands a real good punch, he thinks, okay, that's going to be it then. Hearns will go, and he doesn't.
It's a little arm worry now, and Hearns pulls him in.
Now, no matter who gets the decision, I don't like to control anybody else's life, but I really would like to see Tommy forget about boxing after this fight.
He is not a top fighter. That's simple. He's good, but he is not a top championship
what
fighter.
What is Kinchin waiting for? Oh, and he hurt Tommy now. Look at the guts that Tommy Hearns has. What courage. What, look, Tommy can just about make it. And Kinchin's waiting. Tell me what he's waiting for. That's the reason, Al, that he's never got the big shot with all the complaints. He doesn't have the feel for it.
It's there for him.
Talent, but he doesn't have the feel for it. Now they're yelling heat.
Under 30 seconds to go in the final round, and Hearns slipping there in the center of the ring.
And you the point is, Kinchin may still get, this decision could really go either way.
Oh, yeah.
Very close now.
Very close. Well, the way we see it.
Again,
good solid left to the body by Hearns.
Those, that three-point round now is a big mountain for Tommy to overcome. So
Kinchin just doesn't punch. That's it. It's all over. Hearns and Kinchin go 12. And that is the surprise of the night. Who will get the decision? Well, this is going to be tough to call. As Gil has pointed out, the key here is that big fourth round, a knockdown, a point taken away.
The other rounds were also close, Tim. But that three-point round, I think, is going to be the deciding factor in the scoring in this fight.
Well, you have to feel sorry for Hearns if that's the case in terms of the way he fought the fight and what Kinchin didn't do with that opportunity.
Well, there's no question about it, Tim. I mean, Tommy Hearns showed what it takes to be a world champion. The heart. He knows where he is. He knows how to fire. And he did it under a terrible handicap. He was exhausted. He didn't have a leg under him, and yet he was able to fire back and fight and make this guy respect him for the entire 12 rounds.
Well, you see a real good look at that right eye, just swollen now, shut. Had he had to go another round, he wouldn't have been able to see out of that right eye at all. The heart of a champion, and who knows? Let's find out now. We'll go to our ring announcer, Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's the official scoring. Larry Rosadilla has the bout 114 to 114. Phil Graham scores it 115 to 112. Cindy Barden has it 114 to 112 for the winner, who is now the WBO super middleweight champion of the world, the Hitman, Thomas Hearns!
Well, there you go, Thomas Hearns. Two judges went his way. One scored it a draw. And he did overcome the fourth round.
Well, knockdown for sentimental reasons. Point. For sentimental reasons, you know, you like to see Tommy Hearns win the fight because he showed so much heart. But I certainly thought that it was too much for him to overcome that early knockdown.
So there is Thomas Hearns. And again, heart, championship experience, maybe a little bit of luck. Thomas Hearns may find himself with another big fight and another payday. Let's go up to Al Bernstein.
Right, you got Tommy Hearns in here if we can. Tommy embracing James the Heat Kinchin. An excellent effort. Tommy, were you surprised at all you got that decision?
No, I felt that I was ahead on the scoring court. I felt that I was doing the most of the leading the punches. From time to time, I was slack off and tried to pace myself, and as I was trying to pace myself, James made me work. So it was a good fight. I think James is a hell of a fight.
So he fought an excellent fight. How close were you to going out there when he had you down and in trouble?
Well, he had me hurt, but I felt that I shook it off right quick, and I was able to come to.
All right, Tommy, congratulations. Will you? What does this tell you about the future?
Tell me that the future is going to look up. Definitely.
All right.
I know it's definitely going to look up for Thomas Hearns. It's going to get better.
All right, so we'll see you again. Thank you, Tommy. Congratulations. James Kinchin, James, can we get you over here? We'll get James the Heat Kinchin, who came up just barely short in this effort to defend his NABF crown. James, were you surprised at the decision at all?
Very surprised. I felt that I won the fight. It was a close fight, but I feel that I pulled it out. But, you know, Tommy was after a fifth title, and he gave it to him.
It looked like your pace slowed a bit at the end. We thought there were times where if you could have pushed it, of course, you walked in those big right hands. Did you feel like you could have pushed the pace better later? And we'll see the knockdown as you talk about it.
Sure, I feel that I could push the pace, but Tommy is a very dangerous fighter. I was trying to set him up. I had him down. I had him hurt numerous of times. But, you know, what can you say? The guy is coming out for a fifth title, and I'll tell you, he got an early Christmas present.
Well, do you feel like the holding in that round is what saved him? And the point was taken away.
I think so. He was holding on a lot because I was hurting him. I think I was hurting him with a little bit of everything I was throwing, left and right. And, you know, you got to handle man. He's a great champion and all this. But I felt that I was the winner tonight. But no need in crying over spilled milk.
Does this tell you you're fighting much better as a super middleweight than you ever did probably as a middleweight? Does this tell you the future could still hold a title shot for you?
Most definitely. I'm not through. It showed tonight, I'm sure the people seen tonight, that, hey, James Kitchen is not a club fighter. He's a force to be reckoned with. And I showed that tonight, and it's a lot of people's minds out here knew that I won the fight.
Okay, well, James, congratulations on a good effort, that's for sure. James Kitchen falls just a bit short of defending his NABF crown, and maybe there was something he could have done later in that fight, but it didn't get there. Let's go back to Tim and Gill at ringside.
All right, Al. Gill, you've already indicated that you think that Hearn should retire despite this victory, but he's planning on going on. What makes sense, if anything?
Tim, he still has the heart of a champion. He doesn't have the skills any longer. And it's tough, you know, that they don't like to have the end of the trail come, but it is the end of the trail. Now, if Leonard beats Lalonde, that will be a big fight. Tommy Hearns and Sugar Ray Leonard.
But you're saying that it won't be the best fight for Thomas Hearns.
No, I don't know how Ray Leonard's going to come out of his fight with Lalonde either. You know,
we'll
neither guy's getting
out.
any younger.
That's right. Okay, well, let's go to our host, Jim Hill.
All right, Tim, thank you very much. And this, without a doubt, has truly been a night to remember for all the boxing fans here. And if you would like to relive all of tonight's exciting action, what you should do to order it, please call 1-800-232-3527. That's 1-800-232-3527. So for our entire production staff here, along with our announcers, Tim Ryan, Gil Clancy, and Al Bernstein, I'm Jim Hill saying thank you so much for watching, and so long, everybody, from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Wrestling event of the year, available live on pay-per-view in the comfort of your own home. Starrcade 88, True Grit. You'll see Ric Flair take on his number one contender, Lex Luger, while locked inside a steel cage. Plus, the Sting-Barry Windham feud culminates in a no-disqualification all-out war for the U.S. heavyweight title. You're gonna see it all. The Road Warriors, Dusty Rhodes, the Koloffs, the Midnight Expresses, plus much more. Call now to spend your holiday for the best in professional wrestling.
He defends his title for the eighth time with a first-round knockout of Mario Melo. Coming up here on Showtime is the main event, Tommy Hearns versus Michael Olajide. So sit back, relax, and get ready for that one.
Your own open. You set it up, then do it.
Anxiously awaiting tonight's main event, Hearns and Olajide. But the Mora Melo fight just completed, and Ferdy Pacheco standing by in the ring with the winner. Ferdy?
Certainly didn't take you too long. I mean, after all, this guy flew about 28 hours to get here to do a minute's worth of work.
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to thank the Lord for giving me the strength to come out and perform well. You know, I don't like guys that brag a lot, and he saw me at the weigh-ins, and he was, like, smiling a little bit, so he was trying to play me as a joke, so I knew I had to come in here because he underestimated me, you know, watching tapes of me, my previous fights. And I came in here determined, and I knew what I was going to do.
They came in town as a very big banger. He didn't seem to land one good solid shot on you, but did you feel any power to his punches?
I felt power. It was behind the head. He was hitting me behind the head, and the power was like in his forearms because he never hit me with his gloves.
You know, in that knockout, we tried to find out, let's look at our monitor here. We tried to see what punch was it that caused him to writhe around on the floor like if he had a body shot. Now, you're going with both hands here. Do you think that was enough to cause him to writhe around? Now, watch your body shot here. There it is.
I saw it. I hit him right in his floating rib, right down on the left-hand side. And I knew that the Latin fighters like that didn't have no body. I saw.